Addison Ray went from TikToker to famous Instagrammer to co-founder. How are all these creators going from one platform and magically the next day blowing up on the next? In this video, we're gonna talk about why Addison Ray is ditching TikTok for Instagram Reels and what this means for creators on how we can build a diversified personal brand. Let's get started.
Fine.
The bread and spoon is fantastic here. Hola, me llamo Jade. Estoy en España. Estoy comiendo pan en el parque. I'm here actually with my friend Amanda. She edits videos for me and I'm learning Spanish. But in today's video, we're not gonna talk about my Spanish education journey. We're gonna talk about Addison Ray. So about a week ago, the head of Instagram marketing basically announced,
we're no longer a photo sharing app.
They announced they're going from a photo to a video sharing platform with e-commerce features. This is breaking news because for a lot of people like me or other creators, I only post Instagram photos. So what does that mean? Well, Instagram has plans to push more organic traffic if you post more videos. That's basically what they're saying. So how are creators taking advantage of this? Well, I've noticed two of the fallen creators that are killing on the platform taking advantage of Reels. They are predominantly known for TikTok, but because they saw this organic free traffic to get more views and likes, they immediately hopped onto Instagram Reels. One of them is our king himself, Bryce Hall. Bryce Hall, the cutie himself. I actually don't like him. I am more into like blonde hair, blue eyes. Where were we? Bryce Hall is a TikToker. He posts thirst traps, vlogs, and he's most recently posted vlogs on his Instagram Reels. Now, this is different than his regular content on TikTok being more casual. I've noticed he's posting a lot more story times and just more high quality videos, which is interesting for his brand. On average, his video gets 1 million to 2 million views. And for Instagram Reels to be pushing that much viewership on his platform, it really shows that Instagram Reels is really helping with organic traffic. Another example of this is my friend Rod. He posts comedy content about the millennial workforce. Rod has been posting these funny memes for over a year, and he averages anywhere from 100,000 to half a million views to a couple million. And on Instagram Reels, he's getting just as much engagement or even more. The last example I had is Addison Rae, the queen herself. She posts predominantly content related to her skincare brand, but obviously we can see here that her engagement is relatively similar to TikTok, if not better, with her following ratio. So I can see that there's a little bit more emphasis on her Instagram really seeing like, damn, TikTok is our biggest competitor. We really need to push natural organic views to her creators. And that's something that everyone has been asking for. Well, first of all, I think back in 2016, when Instagram changed their Instagram algorithm from chronological to being algorithmic, a lot of people were upset. Many creators felt like they were shadow banned or just like silent. And for a lot of people like me, I was also really upset because I was like, damn, I got 100 likes, now I get 50. I really believe Instagram Reels is not only pushing big creators to the front, but also smaller creators. And that's huge for a platform that has been noted to censor creators and kind of hide them from the algorithm. But Jade, what does this mean for photographers? I'm still posting photos, what do I do? Well, don't you worry. I have tons of friends that are predominantly photographers, but how they're transferring their content into this new video sharing world is by making behind the scenes content. One of my friends is named Alex. He posts photos and portraits, but he's been sharing his photography journey of him shooting strangers and the behind the scenes story of how to make a photo. And his engagement went from this to this. If you're someone that's a model, you can share how-to videos or story times and just share a little bit more about the behind the scenes process of the actual finished photo work. Now, with creators going from TikTok to Instagram to YouTube to just transferring their following everywhere, I think this really shows the importance of decentralized content, which basically means not relying on one platform. If TikTok ever shadow bans somebody, I've been shadow banned before, and I maybe went from 100,000 views to like 5,000 views because of some sort of algorithmic issue, maybe I have Instagram to back it up because then I don't need to rely on one platform. Making sure you're not only just a YouTuber, but a content creator is super important because you don't want to be pigeonholed into one platform and then one day not working out or not relying on it. And I see Addison Rae and big creators really just moving across all platforms so they can just stop being a TikToker and more of a celebrity, a personality, and an influencer. That word is really cringy. So how do you decentralize your content? Well, if you're a content creator yourself, here are some three tips you can follow that I've analyzed and acknowledged, and hopefully you guys can apply this to your brand. The first thing is first have a predominant platform, okay? You don't need to transfer following immediately. I would say pick one platform you wanna focus on. If that's TikTok for you, do that. And then over time, just repost those videos onto Instagram Reels. A really good example of this is Victoria Paris. She started on TikTok, grew to a million followers, launched her Instagram page, which is basically reposting her vlogs. Some of it is original. Now she has a YouTube channel where she does vlogs and longer form content. So I would always say, start on one platform and then expand, and you can just repost content. The second thing is to transfer your audience from one platform to another, you really wanna give your audience a reason. Victoria Paris told people, go follow my Instagram if you wanna see my outfit details. so she would link where her outfit was from, so people had a reason to go from TikTok to Instagram. Personally, when I was first starting YouTube, I would always say, hey guys, if you wanna know when I do my meetups and you wanna meet me in person, follow my Instagram. I am having a meetup in Spain. You should follow my Instagram if you wanna find out. Sorry, I had to pull my own plug. What do you guys think? You guys think I'm really someone that just is a social media guru that talks all about tips and doesn't implement? It's literally everybody in the space. My last and final tip is to post a lot of content that's authentic to you. For example, I think we're living in a space where before you had to pick one niche to be successful, and you can still do that, but what I've noticed is you can pick a bunch of niches, whether it's fashion, lifestyle, and let the audience pick what's most popular, because then you're able to show who you are and then let the market kind of decide if it's gonna work out and get onto the For You page. Let me explain this. So there's a YouTuber named Tana Mojo, our problematic queen herself, and she started with making, you know, story times on YouTube. But then on Instagram, she started to post her modeling photos, her vibes, right? And then now she's started a talent management agency for OnlyFans creators. Then she's going into the boxing scene, you know, going into reality TV, and you can see there's these pillars of content. And I think what's really important for her, she said in a Forbes interview, is she's just picking things that are feeling the most natural to her, and she's only expanding if it's authentic to her, right? So I think it's really important to, you know, if you're gonna post on Instagram Reels, make sure you're a user of the platform, feel authentic to it, right? Like, don't go to a new industry or a new platform just for the sake of views, because you wanna be really authentic to who you are. And, you know, for a lot of people that don't use TikTok, I would just first get familiar with the platform before you decide to post, because then it'll give you inspiration of how the culture works and how the platform really operates. This goes the same for content ideas, right? Like, if you feel like you're a fashion YouTuber and you really wanna go to educational content around Instagram, do it. Like, there's really no boundaries with short form content, because the way the algorithm works is it promotes videos on an individual basis versus on a channel basis. So for example, like, you could have 5 videos that perform bad, but if one does really well and has a high watch time and high engagement, TikTok or Instagram will keep pushing it onto their explore pages, right? So it's really important to experiment, but also experiment within your boundaries of like what you like as a content creator. So going back to the title of this video, which is probably why you came, and probably not to hang out with me and eat a baguette, although I'd really appreciate you if you guys subscribe for more hanging out with Jade vibes. Going back to the title of this video, why did Addison Rae go from TikTok to Instagram? Well, the answer is creators like Addison that are smart go where the traffic is. They go where algorithms and opportunity arise. And Instagram Reels is trying to provide more organic reach than TikTok. That's what they're really trying to do. So more creators are incentivized to post on there. Obviously, Addison will still post on TikTok and all these people will, but I think it's really important to think about, you know, what is your Instagram Reel strategy? Are you reposting content, which is totally fine, or are you creating a new niche within your audience so people really go to one spot for a specific type of content? I don't think there's a wrong answer. You could do both. I personally repost my content onto my Instagram Reels. Some people make originals and some people do a hybrid. So comment below what your plans are as a content creator. Thank you guys for watching. Shout out to the comment winner.
Shout out to the comment winner. Comment on this post to be featured in the next episode.
If you guys want to be the next comment winner, all you gotta do is comment below. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Bonjour. Wait. Adios. Te quiero, Darmanation. Is that right?
Yeah.
Bye.